Facebook is an essential skill, you know, that everyone needs in e-commerce. It's the essential marketing tool. There's lots of ways to supplement. There's lots of different ways to take it, mm-hmm. but you have to master Facebook ads. So my first question is Facebook ads dead?
It's a good question, and the answer is it actually is dead. No, I'm just kidding.
Damn it, what are we doing? Let's get out of here.
It's over.
It's over.
Cut. But so essentially, Facebook ads, a lot of people see it as like dead or like it's not as it used to be. And that's right. It is not as it used to be. And that's how the world is. With marketing, things change. Something that worked 3 years ago doesn't work today. Something that worked even a year ago doesn't work today. Heck, even something that we used to do 3 months ago isn't as effective today. And that's just how the world evolves. With Facebook ads, in an essence, it's a traffic source. That's what people don't understand. It's not a way to make money. It's not like I'm making money with Facebook ads. It's not that people that do Facebook ads are making money with that. They're sending traffic into something that they're making money with or building a business around. What changed is the fact that there is more saturation in the market, which means that costs are more expensive. And that's not essentially a bad thing. That just means that there needs to be a bit more knowledge and you have to approach it in less of a quick money, fast cash type way and more of like a CEO and a businessman. You have to treat Facebook ads not only as a traffic source, but what are you trying to accomplish and what type of traffic you want to bring? You know, it's not only about like running ads to this product or like that's it and then like let's see how much money comes in. A good example will be that as you know and a lot of people do, I run like the Facebook ads group, which has like over 45,000 people, and I run like my student groups and stuff that have thousands of people. And the questions that I always get constantly is, they post a screenshot of like their ads and like, why isn't my stuff working? I'm getting this and this cost per click. I'm getting this and this. Why isn't this working? Am I not targeting correctly? Am I not optimizing correctly? The first question I ask them is not about even the Facebook ads. It's about, show me your product, show me your store, show me your funnel. 90% of the time, 9 out of 10 times, the product is usually complete shit. I'm not even joking. It's so bad that you open it up on mobile. It's not even about product. It's not even about the product. It's about the whole website. I'll go in, I'll open the product page that they're running traffic to on my mobile phone. First thing is, half of the screen is the logo. Second thing is, there's pop-ups coming in from every sector. Wheelio, gamifying, opting in, discounts, coupons.
They just hit a checklist.
I don't even see the product because of all of the pop-ups. Facebook ads is not the problem here. It's that your product and funnel, is you're not sending people to something that even can sell. So Facebook ads is an external source of your actual business. So to answer your question in a nutshell, Facebook ads is not dead and it would actually never be dead, unless Facebook is dead, which would never happen how Mark Zuckerberg is pushing his companies. But Facebook has just changed, you know, in the good and the bad.
It's closing its door to lower quality experiences.
Pretty much,
right? Yeah. Lower quality customer experiences, lower quality store experiences, that's what is happening. So the answer is obvious. Facebook isn't dead,
right?
But businesses always need to evolve, and they're evolving for the better because of this stuff.
Exactly, yeah.
So
yeah.
You just have to, I think that's pretty crystal clear.
Right.
And that's a really interesting point you bring up about the 90-10. It's probably higher than that, you know, like 90% of stores are just not thinking about their experience or their strategy. They're sort
exactly.
of like their overall strategy, their creative funnel. And so, but the thing is, there are Facebook hacks. There are things that you need to know. There are ways to manipulate it and ways to, you know, for scale, ways to not manipulate it, but ways to get scale and get volume and get sales.
It's an algorithmic platform at the end of the day. There's ways to utilize it in better and worse
ways. And there's always, so people who are doing it all the time are going to be better because it's always changing.
Exactly.
And so it's something you do have to engage in, but it's almost not worth engaging until you've really put some good thought into your creative funnel, as we say, right?
Exactly. Yeah, that's the main essence of it.
Nice. So just quickly, so I'm going to bring it back to the nitty gritty for a second on Facebook.
Right,
sure. What are some of the key things that have changed 6 months ago? Is it just about that customer experience? Like, what are some practical things of the ways it's changed in the past 6 months?
Right. So Facebook are not treating the Facebook advertising platform. And more, they're pushing a lot of user experience, And I've actually been on the news and like Weekend Sunrise in Australia and like CBS actually talking about this. There was a big talk about like Zuckerberg where I don't exactly remember the nitty gritty, but the whole privacy, not talking about like the Cambridge Analytica aspect, but the fact is like how you're changing the whole advertising and pushing more user experience, which basically means if your business or your ads are not only compliant, which has always been like that, but they have to actually give out good content, then Facebook will not treat you as well, and you will not actually get customers as well. So the main difference is, first of all, this is a natural difference where there's more advertisers, so costs are more expensive.
Yep.
So the biggest difference is costs are more expensive. And by costs, I basically mean that you're paying more to basically get traffic. So if a year ago or 2 years ago, you would pay, let's say, $10 to get 3,000 people in first world countries to see your ad. Today, you're probably paying $10 to get 1,000 people to see your ads, which is good and bad. Because number one, the thing is that if ads are more expensive, that means that you have to have a higher customer value. And if you need to have a higher customer value, you have to build a legitimate business, which people will see that as a bad thing, but I see that as a good thing, because now you have the option to actually build a sustainable brand that won't make you $100,000 in 2 months, but will make you much more in the long term, because you're actually putting in business aspects and treating it as a CEO.
Yeah.
So that's one of the main aspects. The other aspect is that Facebook wants you to produce actual good content, because now they're showing less ads on your newsfeed. I think if I remember correctly, it used to be like one ad out of like five posts, the organic posts. Today it might be like one out of 10 posts, which means people are seeing less ads. Now that's a good thing and a bad thing. One, the ads are essentially more expensive, but two, people, potential customers react more positively to these ads because they see less of them.
Yeah.
Which means, yes, you'll be paying more for ads, but these customers are gonna be worth more because they're not used to seeing ads. So that's really the main changes that Zuckerberg and like Facebook actually introduced to the market, putting more on the user experience rather than just like pushing in traffic and like sending ads and selling whatever you want.
Yeah. So when it comes to methodologies of actually testing, scaling Facebook ads, what, like, you don't give me your strategies,
right?
But just talk about your sort of philosophy for doing that. Are you a very systematic person? Like, I know you're an interesting kind of person because you've got this creative side,
right?
Where you're thinking very creatively about.